Good morning, students. In last class, we have saw about basic proportionality theorem and the converse of basic proportionality theorem. In today's class, based on those, we are going to solve problems. Okay. So before going to exactly to problems, we will see what is this basic proportionality theorem. You have learnt already in last class, but just I will revise you. What we have learnt in last class, what is this basic proportionality theorem and converse of basic proportionality theorem? Yesterday we have derived the theorem, right? We have proved the theorem. Just we will revise it. Okay, see here, what I told basic proportionality theorem. Basic proportionality theorem tells us that if a line is drawn parallel to, okay, if a line is drawn parallel to any one side of a triangle, if a line is drawn parallel to any one side of a triangle, then the two sides are in the same ratio. That is, here AD divided by DB is equal to AE divided by EC. What I told you, if a line is drawn parallel to any one side of a triangle, here this line DE is intersecting AD at point D and AC at point E. Yes or no? In simple, what you remember, if a line is drawn parallel to any one side of a triangle, then the other two sides are divided in the same ratio here, that is AD divided by DB is equal to AE divided by EC. See, in problems, if word came, if in a triangle here, suppose this line is parallel to this, they will mention, if such thing is mentioned directly, don't worry, go directly using for basic proportionality theorem. If they given the condition, if DE is parallel to BC, your next step should come directly this step. This is nothing but basic proportionality theorem. What we are learning, converse. Converse means reverse of this. The reverse converse theorem will tells us that, converse theorem will tells us that, see here, if AD divided by DB is equal to AE divided by EC, this implies DE is parallel to BC. This is the converse of basic proportionality theorem. Yes or no? If the two sides in a triangle are divided in the same ratio, okay, then that line is parallel to the third side. We have learned this here. Here there are two sides. Here DE is intersecting AB at D and AC at E. Yes or no? See, if AD divided by DB is equal to AE divided by EC, then DE is parallel to BC. Means your ratio should come same. If ratios are same, then we can tell that the DE is parallel to BC. This is nothing but the converse of a basic proportionality theorem. Now we are going to see the problems based on this. Once more I will explain here. If a line is parallel to third side of a triangle, means we have to, by basic proportionality theorem, we have to tell that AD divided by DB is equal to AE divided by EC. If in a problem, if they have given that AD divided by DB is equal to AE divided by EC, then we can tell that these two lines are parallel. Now, based on this, we are going to solve problems. Okay, problem number one. Problems. First problem, if a line intersects, if a line intersects sides AB and AC of a triangle ABC at D and E respectively and is parallel to BC, prove that AD divided by AB is equal to AE divided by AC. The question tells that if a line intersects sides AB and AC of a triangle ABC at D and E respectively and is parallel to BC, prove that AD divided by AB is equal to AE divided by AC. So, you take down the given figure. Okay, this is the given figure. ADEBC. Now, see, students, what they are given? If a line intersects, this is a line DE, okay? A line intersects side, it is intersecting AB at point D, yes or no? It is intersecting AB at point D and AC of a triangle ABC at D and E respectively. Now see here one triangle ABC they have given one triangle ABC. Again they have given this line DE is intersecting AB at point D and AC at point E. And E is parallel to, they told that this line is parallel to and this line is parallel to BC. What we have to prove? We have to prove AD divided by AB is equal to AE divided by AC. They have given the figure and they are telling that this DE is parallel to BC. This line DE is parallel to BC. We have to prove this condition. Now tell me students, I told you that if a line is parallel to a third side of a triangle, means we have to use a basic proportionality theorem. Okay, again I will explain. If they are given this line is parallel to third side of a triangle, anything parallel word comes means you have to use here basic proportionality theorem. Now see here. So your word came, what is that? DE is parallel to PC, means we have to use your basic proportionality theorem. Now take the answer for this solution. See here, given in triangle ABC, DE is parallel to BC. To prove, what we have to prove here, AD divided by AB is equal to AE divided by AC. So this we have to prove here. Now see the proof here. See here. Given DE is parallel to BC. Given DE is parallel to BC. If they are given DE is parallel to BC, by Thales theorem we can write this as AD divided by DB is equal to AE divided by EC. Yes or no? What we can write? AD by DB is equal to
A E by E C. This is by Thales theorem, or we can write by basic proportionality theorem. By basic proportionality. By basic proportionality theorem.
Okay, they have given line DE parallel to BC. We have used the Thales theorem. See here, what I will do? I will reciprocal these two. Now see here, I will reciprocal DB by AD is equal to EC by AE. See, if you want to reciprocal, you have to reciprocal both sides because I want the proof like this. Okay. Afterwards, adding one on both sides. Okay. Adding one on both sides. What it will become? DB by AD plus 1 is equal to EC by AE plus 1. Now see here, the LCM is, the LCM of 1 and AD will be AD only. It will become DB plus AD divided by AD is equal to EC plus AE divided by AE. Now see the diagram figure here. What is DB plus AD? DB plus AD is here. This is DB. Half plus half in full, you know. Half is plus half is full. See here. Diagram. DB plus AD is the full. That will be AB. And see there, EC plus AE will be full, that is AC. So, we will write the next here. What is that? Next step. We will see the next step here. See here, DB plus AD is nothing but AB. AB by AD is equal to what is EC? EC plus AE. It will be EC plus AE will be AC. AC by AE. Okay. Again, I am reciprocal this thing. Or we can write AD by AB is equal to AE by AC. So this was we used to prove. Yes or no? See, AD by AB is equal to AE by AC. This hence proved. Now what we have done? Nothing we have done. Just we have, they have given the condition DE is parallel to BC. We used the basic proportionality theorem. We just reciprocal. Okay. On both side, adding one on both side, okay, adding one on both side, the simplification we have done. Again see here, again what we have done here, AB divided by AD, this we want in a numerator, that's why again we are reciprocal, hence proved. Okay, next we'll see the next problem. Go for the second problem. ABCD is a trapezium. ABCD is a trapezium with AB parallel to DC. E and F are points on non-parallel sides
are points on non-parallel sides. Non-parallel sides AD and BC respectively, such that EF is parallel to AB. EF is parallel to AB. Show that AE by ED is equal to BF by FC. Okay, tell on here whatever they are given the figure. They have given one trapezium here. A, B, C, D, and they have given E, F. Now see, here, students, you knew that what is a trapezium. A trapezium is a quadrilateral. Quadrilateral means a figure which is having four sides is nothing but a quadrilateral. Qua means four. A figure which is bounded by four sides is nothing but a quadrilateral. This a trapezium is a quadrilateral in which two opposite sides will going to be a parallel, and the another two set of opposite sides are not parallel. In trapezium, opposite sides, one set of opposite sides will going to be parallel and another set of lines are not parallel. This is nothing but a trapezium. Now see what they have given. They have given ABCD is a trapezium. ABCD is a trapezium. Yes, we knew that. With AB is parallel to DC. What are they given? AB is parallel to DC. These two are parallel. Parallel means the lines which are not going to meet forever. Okay. E and F are points on non-parallel sides. These are the non-parallel sides. AD and BC respectively. Such that EF is parallel to AB. What are they given? They have given AB is parallel to DC because this is a trapezium. I told you that in trapezium one set of lines are parallel. Yes or no? Here AB is parallel to DC. Again they have given that here E and F are points on non-parallel sides AD and BC respectively, such that this EF is parallel to AB. We have to prove the result. AE by ED is equal to BF by FC. See, these concepts are so simple. Only we have to use here two theorems, that are basic proportionality theorem and converse of basic proportionality theorem. Now see here, therefore answer we go solution given. What they have given here? Given AB parallel to, they have given AB is parallel to DC because this is a trapezium. And again they have given EF is parallel to AB. Definitely we can tell that, see here, if AB is parallel to DC, if AB is parallel to DC, these two are parallel and these two are parallel means definitely these three lines are parallel. Yes or no? See here, this line is parallel to this line. Again they are given this EF is parallel to AB means definitely these three lines are parallel. We can tell that AB is parallel to EF, EF is parallel to DC, both are same. We can tell DC is parallel to AB, DC is parallel to AB and AB is parallel to EF. What we can tell? DC is parallel to this is parallel to AB, AB is parallel to EF. Yes or no? Again, what we have to prove here means to prove AE by ED is equal to BF by FC. This we have to prove here. So to prove this, we are going to do this half construction. What construction we are doing means, see here, join AC, okay, here join AC. This line AC will going to intersect EF. That I will show. We will take a separate here. Okay, we are going to take here separately. Means we will understand very clearly. A, B, C, D, whatever they are given, the same denotions should be there. We have to denote the same thing. Whatever they will give in the figure, no? The same thing we have to take. Don't take whichever you want here. If they are not mentioned anything, means you can take however you want. You can take P, Q, R, S, nothing, no problem. Okay, now see. What I will do construction, join AC, okay, join AC. If you join AC, what will happen? AC intersect EF at point G. AC will going to intersect EF at point G. Isn't it? What it will happen? I am going to join AC. What will happen? If you join AC here, AB, AC will going to intersect EF at point G. Okay? Construction you write down. Construction. Join AC. That is AC intersect line EF at point G. Now we'll see the proof of this. Proof. See, in triangle ADC, I told you that students, these three lines are parallel. Definitely, EG is parallel to DC. Yes or no? In triangle ADC, EG is parallel to DC. When parallel word comes in your mind, what I told you, have to remember the Thales theorem, that is basic proportionality theorem. By basic proportionality theorem, what we can write here? AE by ED is equal to AG by GC. AG by GC. Call it as equation 1. This is by basic proportionality theorem, or you can simply write by BPT also. This is my basic proportionality theorem. Yes or no? It was so simple. Yesterday we have learned, if a line is drawn parallel to any one side of a triangle, then the two sides are going to be in the same ratio. Yes or no? This was the first one. Again we will see in triangle CBA, okay, in triangle CBA FG is parallel to AB. Yes or no? FG is parallel to AB. Again here students, see, a parallel word come means in your mind Thales theorem should come. In your mind automatically the Thales theorem should come. If your word parallel came in, definitely Thales theorem should come into your mind. Now see here, FG is parallel to AB. Means use the Thales theorem. For that also we are going to use the Thales theorem. because a parallel condition is there, that's why we are using that. So therefore, what we can write, if FG is parallel to AB, we can use CG by AG is equal to CF by BF, because by Thales theorem we are writing this, call it as equation 2. This is also by basic proportionality theorem, by basic proportionality theorem, by basic proportionality theorem. See here, now this is my basic proportionality theorem, this condition came. Okay, what I will do, just I will reciprocal this. Okay, why I am reciprocal means, because I want to equate equation 1 and equation 2. Because here AG GC, here AG divided by GC, but here just it is reciprocal, that's why this only I am reciprocaling. That what it will happen, or AG by CG is equal to BF by CF. Okay, equation 3. By equation 1 and 2, what I can write? By equation 1 and 3, I can write it as, see here, compare here, AG by CG is equal to BF by CF. Here, AE by ED is equal to AG by GC. This I can write it as BF by CF is equal to AE by ED. So this only we want to prove, just it has become this when this side, just it is LHS when RHS, RHS when LHS. Just do AE by ED is equal to CF by BF. Okay, this we want to prove. See here, whatever they have given the condition, just we have proved here. That is, AE by ED is equal to, it was BF by CF. Okay, just I have written this side, and this I took this side, because in to prove that was the thing. Okay, so just what we have used the concept, we just use the concept of basic proportionality theorem, nothing we are doing. Next we will go for the third problem. Next, we'll see the third problem. In figure, PS divided by SQ is equal to PT divided by TR, and angle PRQ, prove that PQR is an isosceles. Prove that PQR is an isosceles. They have given in the figure. Now see here, student, a geometry is such a subject that whatever the basic things are there, that all will going to apply here. Okay, to prove any theorems or to prove any problem, basic geometry is needed, very thing. We can't tell that only we can use here basic proportionality theorem and converse. If in your syllabus only basic
proportionality theorem and converse is there, we have to use that only. No, here we have to recollect all the ideas of the geometry. Now see, in figure PS divided by SQ is equal to PT divided by TR. Now who will come in your mind? Definitely we have to use the theorem of converse of basic proportionality theorem. We have to use your converse of basic proportionality theorem because they have given that PS divided by SQ is equal to PT by TR. If they are given parallel condition, we need to use basic proportionality theorem. But they have given that here ratios are equal. If ratios are equal, means we have to use your converse of basic proportionality theorem. Now what they are given here? Solution given PS by SQ is equal to PT by TR. They have given this. Definitely by seeing this, I told you that converse of basic proportionality theorem you have to use. Okay, this implies ST is parallel to QR. ST is parallel to QR. Now see, students, what they have told here, I not saw anything, just I saw this condition I had written. Actually what we need to prove here means PST, this angle S is equal to PRQ. These two angles are equal. They have given these two angles are equal. We have to prove that PQR is an isosceles. We have to prove here PQR is an isosceles triangle. We have to prove here. Now see, what is isosceles triangle? Isosceles triangle means in a triangle the two sides should be, the length of two sides should be same. The length of two sides should be same. Once more I am repeating, isosceles triangle means in a triangle if two sides are equal, that we are going to call a isosceles triangle. Again see, you have learnt in your previous class the property of an isosceles triangle is, isosceles triangles here, for this side which is the opposite angle, for this side which is the opposite angle, it is angle B. And for this side which is the opposite angle, definitely it will angle C. Here these two angles are equal. These two angles are equal. Again, if two angles are equal, their opposite sides are equal. If two sides are equal, their opposite angles are equal. Number one. The second point tells us that if two angles are equal in a triangle, the opposite sides will going to be equal. Now see here, if I ask you one question, see here, I will draw one triangle here, X, Y, Z. If I draw a triangle X, Y, Z, now I will tell you that X, Y is equal to X, Z. Definitely this is an isosceles triangle. So what I told the property, if two sides are equal, their opposite angles are equal. If two sides are equal, their opposite angles are equal. Now see, student, for this side xy, which is the opposite angle? It is angle z. And for this side xz, which is the opposite, for this side xy, the opposite angle is z. And for this side xz, the opposite angle is y. Definitely, angle y is equal to angle z. Angle y is equal to angle z. So now see here, the reverse of this thing I will ask you. If I gave you one triangle, X, Y, Z,
If these two angles are equal, if these two angles are equal in a triangle, what we can tell? The opposite sides are equal. For this angle y, which is the opposite side, student, tell me? Definitely it is xz. For this angle z, which is the opposite side? It is xy. Definitely xy is equal to xz. This you have learnt in a primary standard, just I revised you. Okay, this will going to help you here very much. Okay, they have given, I have written whatever they are given, the first quantity I written here, and also they have given PST is equal to PRQ. Okay, they have given these two angles are equal. Now see, students, again we will go for primary standard, that mathematics we want here to solve this. If two lines are parallel, if two lines are parallel, okay, see here, if two lines are parallel, if you take one transversal, if you take one transversal, suppose here AB is parallel to CD, here EF is a transversal line. Transversal means this is cutting at point here, at two distinct point this line is cutting, yes or no? This line EF is cutting these two lines at two distinct point, means distinct means different point. Yes or no? This EF line is cutting at this point. Here you take this point is different and this point is also different. A transversal means it will going to cut the lines in a distinct point, different points. Okay. Now see here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 angles we are going to form. Here 4, here 4. Okay. Here 4, here 4 we are going to form a 8 angles. Now see here, student. Now, if this is the case, what I can tell here is angle, if a transversal EF is cutting the line, if this, now say students, what I am telling, if EF is a transversal, okay, if EF is a transversal, I told that what is a transversal, transversal means this line is cutting line AB and CD at two different points. Okay, then what we are going to form here, see here, here angle 3 is equal to angle 5. Before going to that, I will revise this here. Here angle 1, angle 2, angle 7, angle 8 are called exterior angles. Exterior means outside, these are exterior angles. And angle 3, angle 5, 1, 2, 3, it should be 4 here. Angle 3, 4, 5, 6 are called interior angle. Yes, these are called interior angle. Now, one exterior angle, this is exterior, no? One exterior angle and one interior angle is nothing but a corresponding angles. These two angles will be equal. Angle 2 is equal to angle 6. These are exterior angle. Again, here angle 1 and angle 5 are one exterior, one interior should be there. This is called corresponding angle. And here angle 1 is equal to angle 5. One exterior angle should be there, one interior angle should be there, that are equal. That we are going to call it as a corresponding angles. Here angle 2, angle 6 are equal, and angle 1, angle 5, angle 1 and angle 5 are also corresponding angles. What I am telling, one exterior should be there and one interior should be there, we are going to call that as corresponding angles. That corresponding angles are equal. Now see a student, here ST is parallel to QR. ST is parallel to QR. Okay. If ST is parallel to QR, what they are given? ST is parallel to QR. Then we will see that here two lines are parallel, right? I told that these two lines are parallel here. The two lines are parallel. That is STQR, these lines are parallel. If here, if this line is a transversal, if this line is a transversal, means what we can tell, this angle is equal to this angle. This is exterior angle and one interior angle. These two angles are equal. Yes, here these two angles will going to be equal. Angle S is equal to angle Q. Angle S is equal to angle Q. Because that are which angle? Corresponding angles. What we can write? Angle PST, angle PST is equal to PQR. Angle PQR. Because corresponding angles. Corresponding angles. See here, corresponding angles are equal. Okay. These are corresponding angles. Now see here, this angle and this angle are equal, I am telling you. Now these two angles we got equal. Okay. If these two angles are equal, what are they given the condition? These two angles are equal. Yes or no? If these, what are they given? Just now I found out that these two angles are equal. What they have given the condition? They have given these two angles are equal. We will write down angle PST is equal to PRQ. This is the given thing. Now see here, compare both these. What we can write? Angle, this implies angle PQR is equal to angle PRQ. Now see here, angle Q is equal to angle Q is equal to angle R. Angle Q is equal to angle R. What I told, if in a triangle two angles are equal, their opposite sides will going to be equal. For this, the opposite is this one, and for this angle, the opposite will be this one. If these two sides are equal, definitely this is an isosceles triangle. Definitely this is an isosceles triangle. Yes or no? What again? Angle PQR is equal to angle PRQ. Therefore, PQ is equal to PR. What is the reason we can give here? Two angles are equal. If two angles are equal, means their opposite sides are equal. Their opposite sides are equal. Therefore, see here, if PQ is parallel to PR, definitely here two sides are equal, means this is an isosceles triangle. Therefore, triangle PQR is an isosceles triangle. Yes or no? This is an isosceles triangle. Okay, we'll go for the next question. We will see the next.
Now see, students, here the concept is problems over. Next we are to see exercise 2.2. Okay, we will see exercise 2.2.
See what we saw here. Just we saw that the problems based on basic proportionality theorem and converse of basic proportionality theorem. We saw the problems, whatever they have given in the textbook as solve. Now we'll go for exercise 2.2. The first question is in figure, okay, in figure 1 and 2, in figure 1 and 2, DE is parallel to BC. Find EC in 1 and AD in 2. Okay, they are given here figure. Okay, take down that figures what they have given. A, B, C. Here they are given line D, E. They are given the length of that. Okay, they have given the length. Okay, this is figure 1 and figure 2. This is the figure 2, whatever they have given, 7.2 centimeter, 1.8 centimeter, and here 5.4 centimeter. Now see here, students, in figure 1 and 2, okay, these are figure 1 and 2, DE is parallel to BC. DE is parallel to BC. Find EC in first figure. We have to find the length of EC in first figure and length of AD in second figure. Now see here, students, I told you whenever they will give the parallel condition, what we have to do? We have to use a basic proportionality theorem. Turn on the solution. What they have given? They have given DE is, this is first one, okay, DE is parallel to BC. By basic proportionality theorem, what we can write? By basic proportionality theorem, we can write AD by DB is equal to AE by EC. So this we can write. What they are told? They are told to find out here the length EC. See, whenever they will give parallel condition, directly will go for using basic proportionality theorem. Afterwards, I will see what they have asked. Okay. Now see, they are told to find the value of EC. Every value they have given, go on substitute here. AD value is 1.5 centimeter. DB they have given as 3 centimeter. AE they have given 1 centimeter. EC we have to find out. So this implies cross multiply it. 1.5 into EC is equal to 3 into 1. We want to find out the length of EC. EC is equal to 3 into 1 divided by 1.5. 1.5 ones are 1.5 twos are. This implies EC is equal to 2 centimeter. The length of EC is 2 centimeter. Like this only, the same thing you apply here and you can do this as. Okay. You can do this one by using the same thing. First one I told you. Second thing, again use the basic proportionality theorem and you can continue here. Next, we are going for the next problem, that is the second problem based on this. The second problem, we will see what they have given here. The second problem was, second one, E and F are, E and F are points, E and F are points on the sides PQ and PR respectively of a triangle PQR. For each of the following cases, state whether EF is parallel to QR. EF is parallel to QR. What are they given? First one, PE is equal to 3.9 centimeter. EQ is equal to 3 centimeter. EQ they are given 3 centimeter. PF they have given 3.6 centimeter. And FR they have given 2.4 centimeter. Okay. And the second question they have given, in second question, the second sub question they have given here, PE is equal to 4 centimeter, QE is equal to 4.5 centimeter. PF is equal to 8 centimeter. PF they have given 8 centimeter. And RF they have given 9 centimeter. And third one, again third is there here, third question. PQ they have given 1.28 centimeter. PR they have given 2.56 centimeter. PE they have given 0.18 centimeter. And PF is equal to 0.36 centimeter. See here, E and F are points on the sides, means one triangle is there, PQR. E and F are points are there on the side PQ and PR. For each of the following cases, state whether EF is parallel to QR. Here, if anything want to be a parallel, the thing is that the two sides should be in the same ratio. See here, they told to prove EF is parallel to QR. When EF is parallel to QR? By converse of basic proportionality theorem, we can tell that when two sides are in the same ratio, then that two lines are in parallel. Yes or no? If see here if triangle ABC is there, okay, here DE is a line, okay, D is a point which is intersecting AB, and E is a point on AC. If AD divided by DB is equal to AE divided by EC, if this condition is correct, then only we can tell DE is parallel to BC. Simply we can't tell. The ratio should be same. The answer should have to be same. So we will solve here. Okay. We will solve the second question. So what they have given? They have given E and F are points on the side PQ and PR respectively. Means definitely that is telling that we have to draw one triangle PQR. We have to draw one triangle PQR. Again, E and F are points. Here E is one point and here F is one more point on side PR. Okay. For different cases, they have given the different sides. We have to see that. Now we will take first one. Okay. First one. What is that first one given things? The first one given things are PE is equal to 3.9 centimeter, EQ is equal to 3 centimeter, PF is equal to 3.6 centimeter and FR is equal to 2.4 centimeter. Okay, now see here. Now we will check the ratio. PE by EQ we will check. PE by EQ. What is PE? PE is 3.9 divided by 3. It will come 3 ones are 3, 1.3s are. This answer will come 1.3 centimeter. Next we will check PF by FR. PF is 3.6 centimeter and FR is 2.4 centimeter. So if you don't know how to divide the decimal, you just multiply and divide both sides by 10, it will become 36 divided by 24. If you multiply and divide by 10, 10, 12 twos are, 12 threes are. 3 divided by 2 is, it is 1.5 centimeter. Now see, is these two ratios are same? No, definitely this is different and this is different. Yes or no? What we can tell? PE divided by EQ is not equal to PF divided by FR. Therefore, in this case, EF is not parallel to QR. In this case, what we can tell, EF is not parallel to QR. Yes or no? See here, PE divided by EQ is not equal to PF divided by FR. This implies EF is not parallel to QR. We can tell this. EF is not parallel to QR. So we will see the second one here. First one we will solve. We will see the second one. Whatever they are given, the second thing, we will just see it. Second one, what are they given? Given things, given PE is equal to 4 centimeter, PE is equal to 4 centimeter, QE is equal to 4.5 centimeter, PE is equal to, I think so this is PF, right? I have written here two times. So PF is 8 centimeter and RF is 9 centimeter. Okay, now see, I again check it. You do PE divided by EQ. Check the ratio of this. PE is 4 divided by 4.5. If you don't know how to divide this, you can tell, do multiply and divide both sides by 10. It will become here, multiplied by 10 and divided by 10. If you do, it will come 40 divided by 45. Then see here, 5 8s are 40, 5 9s are 45. Here the answer is coming 8 by 9. Now same thing you check for PF divided by FR. PF is 8 cm divided by FR is 9 cm. These two are same. Definitely we can tell that. What we can tell? Therefore, PE divided by EQ is equal to PF divided by FR. PF divided by FR means what? Here EF is a line which is intersecting PQ at point E and F at point F at side PR. If these two ratios are same, what we can tell? Here this implies EF is parallel to QR. For this case, these two are equal because here ratios are coming same. So you can do third problem as here homework. You can do third problem, you can solve by yourself. Go for the same method. Next, we're going to see the third problem of this exercise. What they are given, the third problem. So we'll go for third question. The third question is here. Third one. In figure, if LM is parallel to CB and LN is parallel to CD, prove that AM by AB is equal to AN by AD. Now see, students, they have given the figure also here. Okay, they have given the figure for this. A, here it is M, L, B, C, and here they are given N, D. Okay, see here. In figure, this is the figure they are given in textbook. In figure, if LM is parallel to CB. This line LM is parallel to CB. Okay. And this line LN is parallel to CD. We have to prove that AM divided by AB is equal to AN divided by AD. Now see here, students. I told that whenever a parallel condition will come, definitely you don't think about anything. Directly you go for basic proportionality theorem. Whenever parallel will come, no, the word parallel will come in a triangle, definitely you think about basic proportionality theorem. See here what they are given? Solution given, they have given LM is parallel to CB and LN is parallel to CD. They have given this condition. We have to prove here, we will see, to prove AM by AB is equal to AN by AD. This thing we have to prove here. Now see here, proof, we'll go for proof. In triangle, ABC, okay, in triangle ABC, LM is parallel to PC. LM is parallel to BC. I told you that students, whenever the parallel word will come, you have to use a basic proportionality theorem. See here, LM is parallel to BC, use the basic proportionality theorem. AM divided by MB is equal to, this implies AM divided by MB is equal to AL divided by LC. So this is equation 1 by BPT. BPT is nothing but basic proportionality theorem. Also in triangle ACD, LN is parallel to CD. Here again parallel word come, you go for a basic proportionality theorem. That is AN by ND is equal to AL by LC. Call it as equation number 2. This is also by basic proportionality theorem by BPT. Say compare equation 1 and 2. By equation 1 and 2, what we can write? By equation 1 and 2, AM by MB is equal to AN by ND. Say they are told to prove for us AM by AB is equal to AN by AD. What we will do here, we will just reciprocal that the equation. That is MB divided by AM is equal to ND divided by AN. A reciprocal this I got. See, adding equation 1 on both sides, adding 1 on both sides, MB divided by AM plus 1 is equal to ND divided by AN plus 1. Okay? Now, how we can simplify this? MD plus AM divided by AM is equal to ND plus AN divided by AN. So, see your figure, what is given? Okay, we will draw once again. The given figure in the textbook A, B, C, D, here L, M, and this is N. Now see here, MB plus AM, what is MB plus MB plus AM? Half is full, that is AB divided by AM. Yes or no? AB divided by AM. And again, ND plus AN is nothing but AD divided by AN. Whatever they told to prove, it is here. Or we can write AM divided by AB is equal to AN divided by AD. Okay? This they told to prove here. Just what we have done, we have used a basic proportionality theorem, converse of BPT, and we have solved the problems. So whatever I gave you to do, you have to do it and come. If you solve more problems, you will be perfect. Okay. The next exercise, exercise 2.2, the next questions we are going to solve in the next class. Thank you.